I mean, Sholay is a film that means so much to so many people, generations now. I'm curious what that story means to you at this point and how you feel about the continued global love that it receives.
Oh, it's overwhelming, and I'm humbled. I'm humbled that 44 years later, people are still talking about it. It's a damn good feeling. It's phenomenal. It's a phenomenon. I didn't plan it to be a phenomenon. I planned it to be a damn good film. But, God damn it, who will refuse a phenomenon if it comes your way? It only happens once in a lifetime, so great.
As one of our most celebrated and cherished storytellers, what does it mean for you to be a director, to be a storyteller? What is the magic of having that role in life?
Oh, the magic happens later. At that time, it's bloody hard work, believe me. Just trying to put it all together, trying to create while shooting. So often you sort of, on the sets, you recreate without, of course, going off the line, you know, sticking to what you're supposed to be doing. And you, when you reinvent something just like that, it's a great feeling. And it did happen in Sholay like that. Several moments were created on the spot. For instance, there was a massacre sequence. And I was shooting it. There was broad daylight. And then the clouds came in. So I stopped shooting. And then for 2 days, I was sitting without a shot. And I was imagining how this whole sequence would work in a very clouded atmosphere, and wham, it hit me. I started shooting, and it became an ominous kind of feeling because of what was going to happen, and it lifted the scene to another level. So I think it worked beautifully, but it was on the spot.